Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ. Hello and welcome to all of you to this live broadcast of the Angelus Prayer, coming to you from St. Peter's Square here in Rome, on this beautiful day here in Rome on the 24th Sunday in Ordinary Time. In just a few moments, Pope Francis will be coming through the window there of the Apostolic Palace, and he, as he does every Sunday, to greet the pilgrims and visitors below here in the square and to lead us in the recitation of the Angelus Prayer at 12 o'clock. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome all of you and especially our partners who are joining us today. Some of you are joining us through various Vatican Media channels, the Vatican News Live Event app, the Vatican Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News English web portal, YouTube channel, our Facebook live feed, and to all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks, USA, EWTN TV, Salt and Light TV, Shalom TV India, and at Madarshan TV India, UCTV, Uganda Catholic Television. We also welcome those who are joining through Radio Maria England, Luminous Radio India, and all of you joining us through radio stations of all, and all of you tuning in through other local or diocesan radio broadcasts, or those of you picking up the shortwave transmission. We welcome those joining through our American Sign Language broadcast, and all of you joining through other internet sites and digital platforms throughout the world. Welcome to all of you. My name is Bonga Majola, and this is a great joy for me to be able to provide you with the English language translation today. As we know, before leading the recitation of the Angelus, Pope Francis will offer some reflections, catechesis, on this Sunday's Gospel reading, which is taken from the Gospel of Matthew chapter 18, verses 21 to 35. So we will be hearing from him on today's Gospel and reflections on that, followed by the recitation of the Angelus Prayer. And then he will greet all those who have gathered here in the square, pilgrims from Rome and from different parts of the world, as we see flags waving and a very excited crowd as usual, as you can see in these live images coming to you directly and live from St. Peter's Square. We see the banner and the window of the palace where the Holy Father will emerge in just a few minutes' time. We'll listen to his message and we'll receive his apostolic blessings on this Sunday. Here we can see the banner there hanging from the window where Pope Francis will emerge and greet everyone in the square below. And the curtains have just opened, and there comes the Holy Father. We join the crowds as they applaud and welcome the Holy Father.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno.
Il Vangelo ci parla di perdono.
Today the Gospel speaks to us about forgiveness. Peter asks Jesus, Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? As many as seven times? Seven in the Bible is a number that indicates completeness. And so Peter is very generous in the assumptions of his question. But Jesus goes further and answers him, I do not say to you seven times, but 77 times. He tells him that when one forgives, one does not calculate, that it is good to forgive everything and always, just as God does with us, and as those who administer God's justice are required to do, forgive always. This I say always to the priests and to the confessors, to forgive always, exactly like God forgives. Jesus then illustrates this reality with a parable, which again has to do with numbers. A king, after being implored, forgives a servant a debt of 10,000 talents. It is an exaggerated immense value, ranging from 200 to 500 tons of silver. It's exaggerated. It was an impossible debt to settle, even by working a lifetime. Yet this master, who reflects our Father, forgives it out of sheer pity. This is the heart of God. God forgives always because God is merciful. Let us not forgive how God functions. God is close. God is full of compassion and God is tender. This is how God is. Then, however, this servant whose debt had been forgiven shows no mercy towards a fellow servant who owes him 100 denarii. This too is a substantial sum, equivalent to about 3 months' wages, as if to say that forgiving each other costs money, but not at all comparable to the previous one, the one forgiven by God. Jesus' message is clear. God forgives incalculably, exceeding all measure. This is how He is. He acts gratuitously, out of love. With God, everything is gratuitous. We cannot repay Him. But when we forgive a brother or a sister, we imitate Him. Forgiving is not, therefore, a good deed that we can choose to do or not. It is a fundamental condition for those who are Christians. Every one of us, in fact, is forgiven. Let us not forget this. We are forgiven. God gave His life for us, and no way can we compensate for His mercy, which He never withdraws from His heart. However, by corresponding to His gratuitousness, that is, forgiving one another, we can bear witness to Him, sowing new life around us. For outside of forgiveness, there is no hope. Outside of forgiveness, there is no peace. Forgiveness is the oxygen that purifies the air polluted by hatred. It is the antidote that heals the poisons of resentment. It is the way to diffuse anger and heal so many diseases of the heart that contaminate society. Let us ask ourselves then, each one of us, let us think about this. Do I really believe that I have received from God the gift of immense forgiveness? Do I feel the joy of knowing that He is always ready to forgive me when I fall, even when others do not, even when I am not even able to forgive myself? God continues to forgive. Do I believe this? And then, can I in turn forgive those who wrong me? In this respect, I propose a little exercise to you. Let us try now, each one of us, to think of a person who has hurt you. Each one think of a person who has hurt us. And let us ask the Lord for the strength to forgive them. And let us forgive them out of the love for the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, this is good for us. It will restore peace to our hearts. May Mary, Mother of Mercy, help us to receive the grace of God and to forgive each other.
Et concepit de Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Ut dignificamus promissionibus Christi.
Grazie a Tua, in questo Domine, mentre bus nostris infunde, che angelo annunciante, che sti fili tu, incarnazione coniovium, per passione meio se crucem, a resurrezione gloriam, perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine. Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, on Friday I will travel to Marseille to participate in the conclusion of Les Rencontres Méditerranéennes, which is a beautiful initiative that unites all the church leaders and civil leaders to promote the collaboration working towards peace and integration around our Mediterranean Sea. And this is a special intention for the migrants. And this is a big challenge, as we have seen on the news, especially during these past few days. This we have to tackle together, because it is essential for the future of all. And it will help us to arrive at a prosperous future if it is only built on fraternity and putting at the first place the human dignity, human persons, concrete human beings, especially those who are in need. I would like to invite you then to accompany me with your prayers for this meeting. At the same time, I would like to thank the religious and civil authorities who have worked hard and who continue to work hard to prepare for this meeting in Marseille, a city that is very rich with people who are called to be a bridge of hope. So I invite you to continue to accompany me with your prayers. In a special way, I greet all of you people of Rome and many pilgrims from Italy and from different countries, especially those who are representing some parishes of Miami.
La banda de gaitas del batallón de San Patricio.
And then there is the Caritas band of Saint Patrick. They are people from Cairo, and their sisters of the Holy Redemptor, Redemptor from Ukraine, the Church of Ukraine. And let us continue to pray for the battered people of Ukraine, and we continue to pray for peace wherever war is devastating. I greet young people of the Immaculata, and to all of you, I wish you a beautiful Sunday.
Per favore, non dimenticatevi di pregare per me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
And please do not forget to pray for me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
2 minuti per chiudere.
And this brings to the end our live broadcast of the Angelus Prayer this Sunday, the 24th Sunday of in Ordinary Time. As we have heard, Pope Francis has announced his trip to Marseille on Friday, and he has asked us to accompany him and to pray for him during this journey in Marseille. My name is Bonga Majola. It has been a great pleasure to provide this translation, English translation, for you. And thank you very much for having joined us. All our partners, our TV partners, our radio partners, and all of you who have joined us through Vatican Media and Vatican Media channels. So I thank you, and I wish you a beautiful Sunday. We leave you with these beautiful images of pilgrims who had gathered here to listen and to receive the blessings of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. Buona Domenica e arrivederci. Laudato Jesus Christus.